everybody. This is Joe, aka Nerdfist. I got some popcorn and a drink. Let's watch some movies. Guess we better find a seat. I think down front should be good. Excuse me, sir.
This house is a holy place. And even though you never visited me here, I have left behind a few reminders for you. To see that the soul lives on long after death.
When communicating with the dead, it is not necessary to resort to elaborate techniques or obscure occult rituals. It is merely a matter of tuning ourselves to the right frequency. All that is required is a quiet place close to the deceased.
Do you believe in angels, Leah? Your mother believed in them. One more thing. There's an animal that's come out of the woods. You should be careful.
There's something happening.
Hey, calm down. What's the matter?
There's somebody in the house.
I can tell that you're upset, so I want you to trust me, okay? I want you to close your eyes.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the screening room. Today we're going to be taking a look at the movie The Last Will and Testament of Rosalind Leigh. Okay, so this movie is a little bit weird. It basically starts off with this guy, and he's coming home for the first time in 17 to 18 years, and his mother has just died. Don't worry, this is not a spoiler. This is on the back of the box, so I'm not giving anything away. And basically, he's going home to put like the affairs in order to sell off all her antiques and to sell off her home and basically to just kind of oversee the, you know, the last little bits of, you know, kind of putting his mother to rest. And I don't even think he goes to the funeral. He just kind of goes home, you know, to, you know, sell off all this crap. And, basically you come to find out that, him and his mother have, you know, not really spoken, during this time, and she was kind of abusive to him when, you know, when he was growing up, and was very cruel in a lot of ways. And so when he starts going back home, all this weird stuff starts, you know, boiling up, and he starts, you know, seeing things that might not be there or hearing things that might not be there. And because of all the stuff that happened in his childhood, he's, you know, on medication, and he's, you know, seeing a psychiatrist, and so you're never really sure. You know, is he crazy or is this actually happening to him? And it's really weird like that because there really is only one person in the movie. There's a little bit of a kind of a flashback, you know, where he finds this old VHS tape and watches it, and there's people in that. But as far as him interacting with other people, it never happens in the movie, even though it kind of leads you to believe that he's interacting with people, which sounds really weird, but there's like this part where somebody comes to the door and is, you know, kind of telling him, is like, oh, your mother was such a great person, we loved her, you know, she was just such a strong part, you know, of our community. But you never actually see the person. It's just him, you know, looking out of the door. And also with his girlfriend in the movie, you never actually see her, or you never, you know, a lot of times in movies it'll kind of cut back and forth to that person on the phone and then the other person on the phone. Well, in this, it's just him on the phone. And, you know, you never really know, is there somebody there or is he just crazy? Because stuff starts to happen. Weird stuff starts to happen in the house. And while it's never really in your face, how the movie works is just kind of building up this weird kind of energy of just weird stuff going on. Weird music, weird stuff in the house, weird sounds. And even though you don't really see nothing until a little bit later on in the movie, it works really, really well. The whole time, like, my girlfriend was, like, just gripping my hand as tight as she could because it was just freaking her the fuck out. And that's where this movie really, really works. It's really, really, really creepy. And you could tell that they didn't have a lot of money to make this movie, but where they put that money really shows. And one of that is, you know, part of that is in the set design, because the sets in this movie are just amazing. And I can't really help but think that the place where they shot it really looks like this. This is actually somebody's weird house, or it's like some kind of weird museum, or maybe even a weird antique store. But I can't imagine that they actually, actually made a set that looks this weird and this unusual with all this weird stuff in it. Otherwise, it would cost just a ton of money to make because they'd have to rent all this crazy stuff. And also the special effects. And when I say that, I'm talking about, like, CG creatures. Because there is a CG creature in the movie, and it looks really freaking good. No telling how much money they had to spend on it. But when you see it, and there is a part in the movie where you do see it, most of the time it's just kind of hinted at, but later on you actually do see it, and it looks really good, and it's really creepy, and it kind of makes you not want to go outside, because later that night I had to take the trash out, and of course in the back of my mind I was thinking, oh god, what if that creature's over there in the bushes, and that's what I loved about it. It really freaked me out. And I don't get freaked out very often. I love horror movies. I've seen a ton of them. And this one is definitely one of the better ones that I've seen in a really long time. It's not in-your-face horror. It's very slow, very Hitchcockian. So if you don't like that kind of slow-build type horror movies, this is probably not going to be your cup of tea. But if you do like that, and if you have an attention span, you know, that's longer than 3 minutes, I think everybody will, you know, really get a kick out of this. It's really creepy. Get your girlfriend, sit down, you know, make some popcorn, and you'll have a good time. The only thing I didn't like about this movie was the lead actor, and really, I don't really have any reasons to why I don't like him. I just didn't like him. I thought he looked weird. You know, I would have loved to see, like, maybe, you know, a little bit more of a name actor in it. But it's direct-to-video, so, you know, what are you going to do? But other than that, I really liked it. I can't recommend it enough. If you want to check it out, it's in Redbox right now. I'm sure you can get it on Netflix. But The Last Will and Testament of Rosalind Leigh gets a 4 out of 5 diamonds. So yeah, guys, definitely check it out. Let me know in the comment section what I should like next. Like and subscribe. Also, click on the main channel page, and you'll find links to Facebook and Twitter and all that. And of course, you know, the South Park Let's Play. So yeah, check out all those videos. Like me on Facebook. Do all that. Let me know what to watch next. Let me know what movies y'all have been watching. Maybe I'll check them out. Make a video. You never know. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. This has been Joe, aka Nerdfist. I'll see you next time. Bye.
There's something happening.
Hey, calm down. What's the matter?
There's somebody in the house.
I can tell that you're upset, so I want you to trust me, okay? I want you to close your eyes.